हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग वीडियो. दिस इज सुंदर फ्रॉम कैनरी कैपिटल सॉल्यूशंस. द टॉपिक व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू सी टुडे इज शुड यू टेक अ ईएमआई. सो रिसेंटली आई एक्चुअली विजिटेड वन ऑफ माय फ्रेंड्स प्लेस एंड वी आर हैविंग अ चैट. सो ही वाज जस्ट स्पीकिंग अबाउट हाउ ही वाज स्पेंडिंग हिज मनी एंड व्हाट इज हिज इनकम एंड थिंग्स लाइक दैट. So we are just saying that today I am earning about 1 lakh rupees and my household expenses are about 50,000 rupees. So you're saying I have got another 50,000 rupees where I can actually pay a EMI and actually buy a house. I was really shocked, and in fact this is one thing which has become very common today. So we come from a society where we think that borrowing money is not a very good thing to do, but today the financial institutions have become very clever and they've coined this term called EMI instead of saying it as loan. So the moment we started saying this as a EMI, we never thought that it was as bad as a loan. And today our parents, who generally educated us not to borrow money, are the ones who are also pushing us to say, why don't you buy something through a EMI, and especially a house, why don't you buy through a EMI because you can afford it. I think this is the most shocking thing which is happening in the current scenario, where many of us are actually borrowing money under the name of EMI, and most of us are actually going through a very terrible time when it comes to our personal finance. So this term affordable EMI is actually very, very shocking. So today people have started taking decision based on to buy something based on whether they can actually afford an EMI or not. I think that's a very wrong way to look at finance, because you should always buy something if it is actually really needed, and ideally you should save money and buy, and never borrow money for your lifestyle expenses. My friend casually was saying, in fact, one of my car loan is actually about to come to an end. I was paying a EMI of about 20,000 rupees. So since this EMI is going to come to a end, I am also planning to buy another car, sell this car and take one more EMI, which is like swapping your EMI. So most of our life is going towards managing EMI and not really saving enough money to actually take our life better. So by doing this, what have we started doing is, we have started working not for our family, meaning the salary to which we are working is actually not only for our family. We are actually working to pay the bank which has lent us the home loan, to the car loan, to the personal loan, and what all not. So today our responsibilities have actually become lot more bigger, because we are not only working for our family. So this is very clearly visible in the next chart what I am showing. The saving rate, India was always said to be one of the highest savers. Of course, even today we are one of the highest savers, but that number is actually drastically coming down. We used to save about 20-25% of our income, and today it has fallen to about 15-17%, which is actually a worrying sign. And where is this money actually going? It's actually going towards consumption. And this is very visible today, because 20 years before, many of us did not have a bike, and today most of us have 2 bikes or 3 bikes. 20 years before we never had a car, today almost everyone has a car. And things, there's nothing wrong in terms of having those products, but you should never own those products by borrowing or through running a EMI, because that's actually putting a lot of pressure on your overall finance. And the chart is very clearly showing that the consumption has actually increased to about almost 60% of the income what we are earning. So which is like, though good, we have got better lifestyle, but the better lifestyle should also be based on saving, and definitely not everything to through a borrowed money. So I want to draw your attention towards how much you actually pay if you actually borrow money to buy a home loan, and what you can do with that amount is what I'm going to show in this chart. So focus your attention to the numbers what I'm going to tell you. If you have identified a property which is 75 lakh worth, and you want to take a home loan at a rate of about 8%, and the tenure is about 20 years, that means you will actually end up paying about 62,000 rupees as EMI, which means over the next 20 years, you would have actually repaid the bank almost 1.5 crores. you borrowed 75 lakhs, whereas you actually end up prepaying about 1.5 crores, which means 75 lakhs is the cost of property and 75 lakhs is the interest you are paying to the bank. That is what I said before, saying that today we have actually started working for the bank who has actually lent loan to me. On the other end, if you can actually run a same amount instead of doing a EMI, if you can actually do the same 62,000 rupees as a SIP investment for the next 20 years, if you can afford a 62,000 rupees EMI, I am sure you can actually do a 62,000 rupees investment also. If you actually do that, at the end of the 20th year, at an assumed rate of about 12%, which is what our markets have actually delivered, in fact, it is much more, but even at a very conservative number of about 12%, you would have actually created a corpus of about 5.7 crores, which normally is a very impossible target to many of us. So we need to understand what we are doing, because we actually work for, generally we enter into a home loan maybe at the age of 30-35, and if the loan runs for another 20 years, that means most of your working period goes away in terms of paying the EMI alone. So at the end of the 55th year, the EMI would have got ended and you would have been left with a house and no saving. That's like one of the worst things to happen in your life, because you have a house and you don't have money to spend. If you do the other way, if you had saved enough and you've got about 5.5 crores as corpus, with that you can either buy a new house and have a lot of money to even spend and have a better retired life. So just don't take EMI as a very easy thing, because EMI is not free money. EMI is a loan. So every time you want to think of borrowing, or somebody says that take a EMI to buy something, be very cautious, because you are actually putting a lot of trouble on your own personal finance. So what if you've already taken a loan and you're already struggling? I think the first and foremost thing is, first have a little plan, save little money here and there and start closing your loan. So don't wait for the loan to run for the entire 20 years. I think these are small things which we'll have to really do. Another most important thing is, stop taking any new fresh loans until and unless it is really important and emergency to you. So just to summarize, EMI is not free money, EMI is a loan. Please understand that EMI is a loan. Avoid loans at any cost, and definitely do not take a loan for your lifestyle expenses like buying a car or anything like that. SIP is a very superior product than a EMI. So if you can just focus a little bit on your SIP, you can actually create a lot of wealth and you can actually own a lot more products, if at all you are really interested about owning a lot of products, and actually lead a much better life without really being stressed out. So hope you enjoyed this video. Avoid taking any loans. So the next topic what we are going to see is very important, and it's Independence Day special, about what is freedom. So that's what we are going to see in the next video. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel, Canary Capital Solutions, and please press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching.